So, to sum up what we have learned so far, the Kconfig exposes the config options via .config file to Makefiles, which makes the build system aware of those settings. Based on the .config and config.h file, the Makefile system can decide which is the target board, what's the size of the RAM and ROM, which source files should be built and assembled, and in the code which features should be built and which binaries to include in the final ROM image. In the previous lessons, I have mentioned that we have only one Makefile, and together with the Kconfig, it decides what sources are compiled in. Coreboot has quite vast source tree. So how are those all other Makefiles.inc files included? So the main Makefile is looking for them in paths that are written into the subdirs variable. At first, this variable is defined as subdirs equal to dot, which points to the root directory. There is only one makefile.inc file. We can call it main makefile.inc file in the root directory, and it gets included by the makefile. Okay, but where are the subdirs I have mentioned before? So basically, we have to start what the dash y variables are. In the coreboot makefile system, all dash y suffix variables are called classes. The main makefile.inc declares a variable subdirs-y. Some of the paths present in subdirs-y class, defined in the makefile.inc, are present on this slide. The other makefile.inc files use the plus equal syntax to append paths to subdirs-y classes. When the makefile.inc gets included, makefile extends subdirs variable by subdirs-y content from included makefile.inc. This means that path to look for makefile.inc extends as well. The wildcard, for example, is a function which takes a string with a wildcard as an argument. The output of this function is a space-separated list with names of existing files not matched to the pattern which was passed as an argument. For example, the result of $wildcard source slash args slash asterisk is a space-separated list of all files found in source slash arg slash directory. Okay, so I will present you how it looks in the code. I have opened here the main makefile in the coreboot. And as we can see, the main makefile defines the top level variable, as I shown you before, as a dot. So we have the current directory, which is the coreboot root directory, as a top level. Now, the top level is used to include various other makefiles as well as initiate the subdirs variable. And then we have the definition of the evaluation subdirs and stuff. And now, if we look at the first main makefile inc, which is in the read directory, we have other various subdir classes extension for very basic paths like source library, common library, console device, ACPI, and stuff. Also, have the wildcards I have mentioned earlier to include other various makefiles as well. I will also show you how other directories can be included, for example, some specific ones. Let's say CPU AMD PI. And as you can see, this kconfig variable, which I said the .config is included into the makefile, it allows us to use the kconfig variables to, for example, say which other directories should be extended to the subdirs, because this expression evaluates to y. So we have the subdirs dash y if this option is selected. If not, it is just subdirs dash, which is unused expression. So basically, only the directory that is relevant to given option is included.
So as I have mentioned earlier, other makefile.inc files, laying deeper in the source tree,
may extend the subject variable as well. This leads to a recursive process of including makefile.inc file, extending search path, and including another file until subject list become empty. So, to sum it up, we start with including the main makefile.inc from root directory, and then the subdirect is extended by subdirect-y from main makefile.inc. It contains paths to other core directories which should be searched for makefile.inc files. One of the paths is subtracted from subdirect variable and we search for makefile.inc there. If it exists, it gets included. If it contains subdirect-y, it further extends the subdirect variable. The process finishes when the subdirect variable becomes empty. As I mentioned earlier, there are also other classes defined in the makefile.inc files. The most important could be the RAM stage, ROM stage, and boot block. Their names correspond to the coreboot boot stages to which they are related to. The coreboot boot stages are as follows. The first one is the boot block, which contains the reset vector, pre-caches RAM setup, and the actual caches RAM setup. The ROM stage runs already from the caches RAM and does the early silicon initialization and the main memory setup. RAM stage runs entirely from the main RAM memory and does the normal device setup, mainboard configuration, and the rest of silicon initialization. And the payload stage does not contain any class, but I will just enlist it as for completeness. This is the OS or application bootloader or any other executable that the coreboot should load at the end of the boot process. The makefile.inc files, which lay deeper in the source tree, for example in the mainboard directory or other directories, usually add some other files that should be built to those classes. In this short example, we instruct the build system to build the gpio.c and your irqroot.c as a part of the RAM stage class block. And after the build process finishes, we will see the output files and they will be split by the class names in the build directory. There will be other build directories such as the build RAM stage, build ROM stage, boot block, and other stuff. Which will contain the compiled object files that were previously appended to given class. So let's have a quick look at the code. I have opened here the makefile.inc file from the source lib directory, and as you can see here, there are various classes like the compressor, the boot block, first stage, and stuff. So basically, here we have basically the sources which are included into the final boot block program, and we can see this is the class because it is suffixed with dash y, and here we add some other of the source files to be compiled. We can even use this trick with the kconfig value which I have described when explaining the subdirs. It works the same way. So if it is boolean, it evaluates to y if it was selected, and basically adds the gpioc, for example, to the boot block program. We have also some other classes like first stage, which is used for vboot and the ROM stage and stuff. So if we have something else we want to do, for example, when we have an negative boolean value, for example, like we don't want to include the source file if the no edit fill fb, for example, is not set. So basically we check whether this option is not set and then we include. So this is kind of inverted logic, and that is why we need to use if. And it also works very well with these kconfig options. To show you yet another example of makefile and kconfig connection mechanism, let's go back a little bit to the subdirs variable.
So I, on previous slides, I have shown the subdirectory-y declaration in the main makefile inc. The makefile.inc adds the source mainboard and the mainboard variable to subdirectory-y, as presented in this short example. We can also see that the mainboard dir variable comes from config underscore mainboard underscore dir, which is selected by the kconfig when we set the queuing mainboard. This makes that only the mainboard directory for this particular board is added to the subdirs variable. Okay, I will show you in the code how those relations are realized. So here I have the main kconfig for the QMQ35 board from the emulation. And here you can see that this whole file and all these options are guarded by a board emulation QMU option. But where this option comes from? It comes from the kconfig.name from the same directory, which just gives the name for the menu config, which should be displayed to select this given board. On the other hand, this config option is also defined in the it is also included in the in the kconfig of the emulation object. So it means from the vendor directory, there is also a kconfig that just uses and the settings to select the vendor, and then it sources all the kconfig files from the given vendor. So you can see this is the wild card that allows us to include more boards. But as I can also, as I have shown you, the mainboard dash dir, the mainboard underscore dir is populated from these kconfig files, and these variables are actually used across the whole source to include various other stuff. So we, as you can see, here we include other makefile.inks based on the mainboard directory. So it allows us a more fine-grained selection of what should be compiled and or not. So going back to the kconfig of the QMU, we see that there are some board-specific options which are selected for this particular board, and they actually define what are the board-specific options, what hardware does it use, and stuff. So for example, if we have something like VBoot, so we can change the ROM size, or whether we have some native VGA in it, whether we have TPM and stuff. For example, the subbridge option. This option tells us what is the subbridge for this board which is used, and it already gives us a lot of information. For example, where to look for this kind of option. So we may suspect that this will be in the subbridge Intel, and we can search for this particular model here, and here it is. We may open the kconfig file from this subbridge to see what is included. So as we can see, the subbridge option also have its own specific options which are selected. And this is actually good because we just only need to know which subbridge is used by the board, but we don't have to know actually what a given subbridge feature set is. So actually, we have some kind of basket called the subbridge Intel model, which includes us all the necessary and the subbridge specific options for us in the target main config file. There are other syntaxes in the kconfig, for example, like this one. So VBoot is an option which is selectable by the menu config. But when the vboot is selected, and it unlocks many other options. And as I have said in the previous slides, there are many, many other options which may not always be related to a given board. So here we can, for example, select options that are specific for this board when the config vboot is selected. So basically, this automatically selects other options that are necessary for this platform to have correct operation of vboot. And here I also mentioned that there is mainboard underscore dir variable, which is populated by each mainboard, and it is used to populate many other paths in the whole coreboot build system and make files. For example, here you may see the flash mob descriptor files, and they are actually populated with the mainboard dir because they lead to the board specific flash mob description files. Let's move further with the Makefile and kconfig connection. If we take a look back, we can see that the main makefile.inc adds all SOC, north bridge, south bridge, and other directories to the subdirs dash y, regardless of chosen platform. But if we open one of the makefile.inc files from those directories, we will see that there is a property if equal check at the beginning of the file. So its content is only exposed to the main makefile if corresponding config option has been selected earlier during a build configuration phase. In such way, only the system on chip, soft bridge or no bridge specific code and options are included. In such case, it is, for example, this Intel module soft bridge. So let's see quickly how this works. I have opened the makefile.inc file, which corresponds to the subbridge. And as I have mentioned in previous slides, the kconfig dependencies and selections select all the options and hardware that are specific to the board. So for example, if we have this mainboard emulation Q35, which selects this subbridge, it means that all these subbridge related features and source code will be compiled. And how it works? So if the main makefile includes those for us, let's see the makefile.inc for the subbridge, and we see this is this check for this particular config option that checks whether we have this subbridge included in our configuration, and if yes, it compiles this specific source code from the subbridge Intel model directory. Well, it may also include a source file from other directories as well, if it makes any sense, and if it is a directory that contains some common code.